Hello students, welcome to my channel and Indian Polity MCQ series. Today's topic is Election Commission of India. Election Commission of India is one of the most important topics for many competitive exams. So in this video, we will discuss about the most important questions related to Election Commission of India. If you didn't subscribe my channel yet, or if you are new on my channel, please hit the subscribe button. Click the bell icon so that you can get the notification of my new videos. Let us start from the first question. Which part of the Constitution of India consists of articles on elections? Options are given here. You must know about the part in which the Election Commission of India is mentioned. In which part it is mentioned? It is mentioned in part 15. Of Indian Constitution. Which article of the Indian Constitution makes the provision for an election commission in India? Options are given here. Which is the correct option? The correct option is Article 324. In Article 324, Election Commission of India is mentioned. Which articles in the Constitution give provisions for the electoral system in our country? Options are Article 124 to 128, Article 324 to 329, Articles 256 to 259, Articles 274 to 279. What is the correct answer? The correct option is Article 324 to 329, means option B. Chief Election Commissioner of India is appointed by? Options are UPSC, Prime Minister of India, President of India, none of the above. What is the correct answer? The correct answer is President of India. Now the question is, which is the smallest Lok Sabha constituency in general election by area? Options are Delhi Sadar, Mumbai South, Kolkata Northwest, Chandni Chowk, Delhi. So what is the correct answer? The correct answer is Chandni Chowk, Delhi is the smallest Lok Sabha constituencies in general elections by area. The number of seats reserved for scheduled caste in the Lok Sabha is? Options are 59, 79, 89, 99. The correct option is 79. Now we must know some important facts about the reservation of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes in Lok Sabha. As per order issued by Delimitation Commission in 2008, 412 seats are for general, 84 seats are reserved for scheduled caste, and 47 seats are reserved for the scheduled tribes. In which year first general elections to Lok Sabha were held in India? Options are 1948, 1949, 1950, 1951. The correct option is 1951. Who was the first Chief Election Commissioner of India? Options are given here. You have to select the correct option. The correct option is option C, Sukumar Sen. Which of the following committee recommended that election commission should be a three-member body? Options are Tarkunde Committee, Ashok Mehta Committee, Jeevan Reddy Committee, Dinesh Goswami Committee. The correct option is Tarkunde Committee. Who among the following is the first woman in India to head a state election commission? The correct option is Neela Satyanarayan. She was the first woman in India to head a state election commission. In which year two additional commissioners were appointed for the first time in Election Commission of India? Options are 1980, 1985, 1989, 1991. The correct option is 1989. In 1989, first time Election Commission of India became the multi-member body. Prior to this, Election Commission of India was single member body. Let us discuss some important facts about this question. Election Commission of India consists of Chief Election Commissioner and two Election Commissioners. For the first time, two additional commissioners were appointed on 16th October 1989. This is a very important point. But they had a very short tenure till 1st January 1990. Later on 1st October 1993, two additional election commissioners were appointed. The concept of multi-member commission has been in operation since then with decision-making power by majority vote. Sushil Chandra is the current 24th Chief Election Commissioner. And the two election commissioners are Rajiv Kumar and Anup Chandra Pandey. Under which of the following provision is the booth level officer appointed? Options are Section 13(b)(2) of the Representation of the People Act 1950, Section 13(c) of the Representation of the People Act 1950, Section 26 of the Representation of People Act 1950, Rule 14 of the Registration of Electors Rules 1960. The correct option is Section 13(b)(2) of the Representation of the People Act 1950. Which form number is prescribed for inclusion of name in electoral roll as overseas electors? Options are Form 6, Form 8, Form 6A, Form 8A. The correct option is Option C, Form 6A. In NCT of Delhi, electoral rolls are maintained. Options are parliamentary constituencies wise, assembly constituencies wise, both A and B, none of the above. The correct option is Option B, assembly constituencies wise. What is the maximum permissible limit of distance normally for voters to reach his or polling station? Options are up to 1 km, up to 2 km, up to 3 km, up to 4 km. The correct option is Option B, up to 2 km. In case of lost EPIC electoral photo identity card or voter ID card, duplicate EPIC can be issued on payment of prescribed fee of rupees. The correct option is 25 rupees. Now the question is, how many maximum candidates can be set in one ballot unit? Options are 24, 16, 28, 32. The correct option is 16. When the electronic voting machines EVM were tried for the first time on an experimental basis in India? Options are 1986, 1981, 1982, 1987. The correct option is 1982. Now match the following. You have to match use of EVM with constituencies or year. EVM were tried for the first time on an experimental basis in the by-election to North Peravur Assembly constituencies in Kerala for a limited number of polling stations in 1982. Then the EVMs were first time used on an experimental basis in selected constituencies of Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Delhi. The EVM were used first time in the general election entire state of the Assembly of Goa in 1999. All by-elections and state elections were held using EVMs. Encouraged by this, election commission decided to use only EVMs for Lok Sabha elections in 2003. So all options are matched correctly. So what is the sequence of the matching? A, B, C, D. So the correct option is A. The EVM is closed at the end of poll by. Options are candidate, returning officer, ERO, polling officer in charge. The correct option is polling officer in charge. The use of EVMs and electronic voting was developed and tested by in the 1990s. Options are the state-owned Electronics Corporation of India, Bharat Electronics, Reliance India Corporation, A and B. The correct option is option D, A and B. The state-owned Electronic Corporation of India and Bharat Electronics both developed and tested the use of EVMs and electronic voting in India in 1990s. EVM after polling and before counting is kept in. Options are RO office, ERO office, strong room, ECI office. The correct option is strong room. The last part of the electoral roll. Options are, is concerned with the additional supplement, is for electors who hold a declared office, is concerned with service electors, is concerned with those electors who have appointed a proxy electors on their behalf. The correct option is option C, is concerned with service electors. EPIC, Electoral Photo Identity Card or Voter ID Card, does not contain, let us see, it contains facsimile signature of ERO, then hologram, then it also contains elector's photograph, but it does not contain facsimile signature of DEO. So the correct option for this question is option D. Option D is the correct answer, facsimile signature of DEO. Which of the following is essential for being eligible to cast a vote? Having EPIC, having passport, having ration card. These three options are not very important, but the most important is having name enrolled in electoral roll. If any person name is enrolled in electoral roll, he or she is eligible to cast a vote. So the correct option is option D. Who is responsible for preparation of electoral roll? Options are given here. What is the correct option? The correct option is option C, electoral registration officer. Now, symbols to the political parties at the time of election are allotted by, this is very simple question, the correct option is Election Commission of India. What is the full form of NOTA? Options are given here. What is the correct option? This NOTA is also very important term in Election Commission or election procedure in India. So, what is the full form of NOTA? The full form of NOTA is none of the above. Who was the first woman to become a chief election commissioner of India? This question is very important. You must know about this question. This question has been repeatedly asked in many competitive exams. V.S. Rama Devi was the first woman to become the chief election commissioner of India. So the correct option is option A. V.S. Rama Devi was the first woman to become a chief election commissioner, and she occupied the office from 26 November 1990 to 11 December 1990. Means her tenure was very short. She held the office only for 15 days. For the election commission at the district level, who acts as the district returning officer? Options are given here. You have to select the correct option. The correct option is district collector. Option A. Now, you also need to know that who is returning officer. The returning officer of a parliamentary or assembly constituency is responsible for the conduct of elections in the parliamentary or assembly constituencies concerned as per the representations of the People Act 1951. Now fill in the blank. The commission issued the code of conduct for the first time in, you have to fill the blank here, for the which Lok Sabha elections, and has revised it time to time. So the commission issued the code of conduct for the first time in 1971 and in 5th Lok Sabha elections. Option C. The law for the registration process for political parties was enacted in, options are 1989, 1978, 1979, 1975. The correct option is 1989. Now the question is, which of the following is not correct about Election Commission of India? First option is, the Election Commission has the right to allow symbols to the political parties. This is correct. It gives recognition to the national party, state parties, and regional parties. It is also correct. The commission prepare electoral rolls and update the voters list from time to time. It is also correct. Election commission can allot same symbol to two regional parties even if they are not in the same state. This is not correct about the election commission. Election commission cannot allot same symbol to the two regional parties even if they are not in the same state. So option D is the correct answer. To curb the growing influence of money during elections, the election commission has made many suggestions and changes in this regard. Which of the following is not correct about these suggestions and changes? The commission has appointed IRS officials of the Income Tax Department as election observers of all elections and has fixed the legal limits on the amount of money which a candidate can spend during election campaigns. These limits have been revised over time. This is correct. The Election Commission, by appointing expenditure observers from the Indian Revenue Service, keeps an eye on the individual account of election expenditure. This is also correct. The commission takes details of the candidate's assets on affidavit at the time of submitting nomination paper, who are also required to give details of their expenditure within 30 days of declaration of results. It is also correct. The campaign period has also been reduced by the commission from 21 to 14 days for Lok Sabha and assembly elections to cut down election expenditure. This is also correct. 2. decriminalize politics. The Election Commission has not approached the Supreme Court to put a lifetime ban on convicted politicians from contesting elections. This is incorrect about the suggestions and changes of Election Commission of India. Because to decriminalize politics, the Election Commission has approached the Supreme Court to put a lifetime ban on convicted politicians from contesting elections. So the correct option for this question is option E. To prevent electoral fraud, in 1993, EPICs or electors' photo identity cards were issued, which became mandatory by the which election? Options are 2004 elections, 2009 election, 2014 elections, 2019 election. The correct option is option A, 2004 elections. However, ration cards have been allowed for election purposes in certain situations. Which of the following is correct about the voter verified paper audit trial, VVPAT? The introduction of voter verified paper audit trial, VVPAT, in 8 Lok Sabha constituencies in 2014 Indian general elections was a big achievement for the Election Commission. This is correct. This voter verified paper audit trial system was first used with EVMs in a by-poll in September 2013 in Noksen Assembly constituency in Nagaland. This is also correct. From September 2013 onwards in various legislative elections in the country. This is also correct. So the correct option is all the above. When and where was photo electoral rolls with photographs of candidates on the EVMs were first introduced? It was first introduced in 2015 in Bihar legislative election. Now the question is, the none of the above or nota option was first used in the 2013 assembly elections held in which four states and the union territory? This is very important question. When it was first used? It was first used in Chhattisgarh, Mizoram, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh and the union territory of Delhi in 2013. So the correct option is option A. In which judgment the Supreme Court of India directed the use of nota in the context of direct elections to the Lok Sabha and the respective state assemblies? Options are given here. The correct option is PUCL versus Union of India judgment 2013. So the correct option is option C. Now the question is, when did the Supreme Court of India give the verdict? The nota option will no longer be applicable in the Rajya Sabha election and the Legislative Council election. In 2018, the Supreme Court of India gave the verdict that the nota option will no longer be applicable in Rajya Sabha election and the Legislative Council election. So the correct option is option A. The bench had reserved for judgment on a petition filed in 2017 by Gujarat Congress leader Shailesh Manubhai Parmar to do away with the nota option in Rajya Sabha elections. When was the specific symbol for nota a ballot paper with a black cross across it was introduced. Options are on 18 September 2015, on 20 September 2015, on 19 September 2015, on 21 September 2015. The correct option is option A on 18 September 2015. The symbol for NOTA has been designed by options are IIT Kanpur, National Institute of Design Ahmedabad, National Statistical Office, IIT Guwahati. The correct option is option B, National Institute of Design Ahmedabad designed the symbol for NOTA. When did Election Commission organized an open hackathon to attempt hacking of electronic voting machine used by the Commission in various Indian elections. Options are on 3rd June 2017, on 5th June 2018, on 7th April 2019, on 10th April 2015. The correct option is option A on 3rd June 2017. NOTA secured more votes than the victory margin in the assembly elections in Gujarat, it secured in Karnataka also, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan also. So the correct option is all the above, option D. Now the question is, how is postal voting in India done? It is done through electronically transmitted postal ballot papers, ETPB. So the correct option is option A. Let us know some important facts about postal voting in India. Postal voting in India is done only through the system ETPB of Election Commission of India. Ballot papers are distributed to the registered eligible voters who return the votes by post. Postal votes are counted first before the counting of votes from the EVM. People in preventive destination can use postal vote. Prisoners cannot vote at all. Only certain categories of people are eligible to register as postal voters. They are employees working in the Union Armed Forces. This is correct. Employees working state police as well as their spouses. This is also correct. Those working for the Government of India who are officially posted abroad. This is also correct. So the correct option is all the above, D. Voters, those who are registered for the postal vote are called as the options are preventive destination voter, defense voters, service voters, correspondent voters. The correct option is service voters. C option is correct. When was proxy voting introduced in India? It was introduced in 2003. Now we need to know what is proxy voting. A classified service voter, an armed or paramilitary personnel residing outside their state, government official posted outside the country is allowed to nominate a resident in the same constituency as a proxy to cast a vote on his behalf in his absence. Rearrange the following chief election commissioners of India according to the position of their power in ascending order. T. Swaminathan, he held the office from 7th February 1973 to 17 June 1977. S.P. Sen Verma, He held the office from 1st October 1967 to 30 September 1972. Sukumar Sen, he held the office from 21st March 1950 to 19th December 1958. Dr. Nagendra Singh, he held the office from 1st October 1972 to 6th February 1973. So what is the sequence? The sequence is C, then B, then D, then A. So the correct option is option 3. Rearrange the following Chief Election Commissioners of India according to the length of their tenure in descending order. M.S. Gill, he held the office from 12 December 1996 to 13 June 2001, means he works for 4 years, 6 months, 1 day. T.N. Session, he held the office from 12 December 1990 to 11 December 1996. Means for 6 years. V.S. Rama Devi, she held the office from 26 November 1990 to 11 December 1990 for 15 days only. S.L. Sagdar, he held the office from 18 June 1977 to 17 June 1982 for 5 years. So what is the correct sequence here? The correct sequence is C, because V.S. Rama Devi worked only for 15 days. Then M.S. Gill held the office for 4 years, 6 months, 1 day. Then S.L. Sagdar held the office for 5 years. Then T.N. Session, he held the office for the maximum period of 6 years. So what is the correct option? The correct option is 2, C, A, D, B. Which of the following is not correct about the Election Commissioner of India? The commissioners hold their offices for a period of 6 years or up to the age of 65 years, whichever comes first. The commissioners receive the same perks and pay as Supreme Court judges. The only way a Chief Election Commissioner can be removed from the office is upon an order of the President supported by the Parliament. These three options are correct. The Election Commissioner or Regional Commissioner can only be removed from office by the Parliament. This is incorrect, because the Election Commissioner or Regional Commissioner can only be removed from office by the Chief Election Commissioner. The Chief Election Commissioner and the Election Commissioner are appointed by the President of India. The Election Commissioner or Regional Commissioner can only be removed from office by the Chief Election Commissioner. So the correct option is option D. In 2009, just before the 2009 Lok Sabha elections, which Chief Election Commissioner sent a recommendation to President Pratibha Patil to remove Election Commissioner Naveen Chawla? Options are N. Gopalaswamy, S.Y. Qureshi, B.B. Tandon, Achal Kumar Jyoti. The correct option is N. Gopalaswamy. In 2009, just before the 2009 Lok Sabha elections, Chief Election Commissioner N. Gopalaswamy sent a recommendation to President Pratibha Patil to remove Election Commissioner Naveen Chawla, who was soon to take office as the Chief Election Commissioner and to subsequently supervise the Lok Sabha general election. A potential conflict of interest considering his partisan political party behavior. The President opined that such a recommendation is not binding on the president and hence rejected it. Subsequently, after Gopalaswamy retirement the next month, Chawla became the chief election commissioner and supervised the 2009 Lok Sabha general elections. For solving this type of question, you need to know about the tenure of chief election commissioner. N. Gopalaswamy held the office from 30 June 2006 to 20 April 2009. S. Y. Qureshi held the office from 30 July 2010 to 10 June 2012. B. B. Tandon held the office from 16 May 2005 to 29 June 2006. Achal Kumar Jyoti held the office from 6 July 2017 to 22 January 2018. So if you know the time period or service period of the chief election commissioner, then you can solve this type of question very easily. So the correct option for this question is option A.